Once again, welcome back students. In the final part of tracing of curves, as we have seen in last three sessions that the curves are important, and to sketch curves it will be a tedious process if we'll go using the point by point tracing. So rather using point by point tracing, we have decided to go with the properties of the curve, either they are the Cartesian curves or polar curves. In last three sessions we have seen that how we can plot Cartesian curves. Today we are going to discuss that how we can trace polar curves and what are the properties that we have to take in account to trace a polar curve. So starting with sketching of polar curves, as earlier we discussed that what is polar system and how a point can be described in a polar system, as well as what is relation between polar and Cartesian coordinates. The properties that we want to take in account to trace a polar curve are symmetricity of the curve with polar axis, normal axis and pole. The second property is pole and tangents at pole. Third one is extent, region or plane in curve will lie. The region where curve will lie. And the last but not least property of the polar curve is special points on the curve. Let us discuss that this property is in deep. Symmetricity. Symmetricity, as we mentioned earlier, we will find out with respect to polar axis, with respect to normal axis and with respect to pole. Polar axis is the axis for which we are using angle theta as zero. We say that the given curve is symmetrical to polar axis, which you can see here in this slide, that we have given a curve, we have drawn a curve which is having its mirror image. If we put mirror here on this axis, on either side, whatever curve here we are having on the values of theta for 0 to pi will have the same values of the curve, rather we will have the same points on the plane from pi to 2 pi or between pi to 2 pi. So that is called symmetricity with respect to polar axis. And as you can see that a point can be obtained on the either side. If one side point is given, the point on the either side can be obtained using the same distance that a point have on the one side. That is, if this distance is r, we will use the same distance r. Just using negative value of the angle made by the line joining the point with pole, that is called polar angle, will take it in same magnitude but in opposite direction, and that will give us minus theta. Clockwise direction we have chosen, so minus theta. So this point, if we use polar axis as mirror, this point will be reflected at this point. And similarly, if we go with the each point which lies in this part of the curve, they will be reflected here somewhere. And therefore, to check symmetricity of the curve, we will replace theta by minus theta in the equation of curve. Now, symmetricity with respect to normal line. The curve shown here, we can see that it has the mirror image on the either side of this axis. This axis is called normal axis in the polar system. It makes an angle pi by 2 with the polar axis. Normal axis symmetricity, to check that the curve is symmetrical with normal axis or not, whatever angle a point which is here, say r theta point, makes with zero axis, rather zero line, theta equal to 0 line, it should be same if we consider the point on the either side, but from pi in the reverse direction. Means to check that the given curve is symmetrical to the normal axis or not, we'll replace in the equation of curve theta by pi minus theta. At the same distance, points should be there on the curve, but angle that it makes with the polar axis should be this pi minus theta. So whatever angle here, that should be the same angle but in opposite direction, and that can this can be measured for all the points which lies here on this curve. If the equation of curve does not get changed when we replace theta by theta, when we replace theta by pi minus theta in the equation of curve, we say that the curve is symmetrical with normal axis. To check the symmetricity of the curve with respect to pole, the curve is said to be symmetrical with respect to pole if either the equation of curve remains unchanged when we replace theta by pi plus theta, or it contains even power of r, this is misprint, or by so it is said that if we replace theta by pi plus theta. Now let us see, we are having a point here, say r theta, that means this distance is r and this angle is theta. We have to keep the same distance r, but we have to choose an angle which is pi plus theta. The angle pi plus theta should be measured from theta equal to 0. So here we'll have pi somewhere, theta equal to pi, and we have to add the same angle that was here with 0 with pi. So the point which is r theta will be, the reflection of it will be somewhere here at r pi plus theta. So similarly, whatever point lies on this curve having different r and thetas, that can be, or their images can be obtained here in the third quadrant if we replace theta by pi plus theta, and that gives us symmetry with respect to pole. If we put a mirror here, we should have on the either side, on each side from the pole, the identical figure of the curve. The curve is said to be symmetrical with respect to theta equal to pi by 4 line if the equation of curve remains unchanged when we replace theta by pi by 2 minus theta. Theta equal to pi by 4 line means, here if we consider this figure, this will be considered as theta equal to pi by 4 line. Theta equal to pi by 4 line. Now if we do pi by 2 minus theta, if we replace theta by pi by 2 minus theta, so whatever curve's figure here before pi by 4, it will remain same after pi by 4, and in that case we will declare that the curve is symmetrical to theta equal to pi by 4 line. The similar type of symmetricity we can check with respect to theta equal to 3 pi by 4 line by replacing theta equal to 3 pi by 4 line in the equation by replacing theta by 3 pi by 2 minus theta. Pole and tangents at pole. So likewise, origin we are going to find out here the curve will pass through pole or not, and if it pass through pole, then what will be the tangents at pole. Curve pass through pole if there exists some theta for which r is 0. If a curve wanted to pass through pole, it should have the r's value 0. Now pole is a point which is at distance 0 from on each theta equal to constant line. So what we will do, we'll replace r by 0 in the equation of curve. The equation will be f theta equal to 0. Solving that equation for theta's values, we'll get the values of theta where r can be 0 on the curve. and we'll generate or we'll make the points r comma theta using these values. This will be the values, or this will be the r comma theta points where cow can pass through the pole. We'll consider theta's value obtained this way as tangents to the pole at the particular point, and these points will also guide us to trace the curve in what manner, in what direction, considering tangents. Extent. The extent of the graph of polar curve involves the set permissible values, the set of permissible values of r and theta. That is, those values of theta for which r is negative or imaginary cannot be part of curve. So in the equation of curve, we'll try to find out those thetas for which r can be negative or imaginary. We'll not take that values in account, and we declare that for these values of r and theta, the curve will not exist. The second property that we'll consider is minimum value of, we'll find out minimum value of r using different values of theta. This value of r equated with constant, that is, if we use r equals to a, then it will give us a circle having radius a, and this means that our curve is not exceeding this circle or is not coming out from this circle. Our curve totally lies inside this circle. That will give us boundary of the curve. Now next point is special point on the curve. For different values of theta, we'll find out corresponding values of r using equation of curve, and we'll prepare a table for theta versus r. What we'll do, once we obtain that theta is symmetrical to this line or that line, these are the values of theta for which r is not negative or not imaginary, that is boundaries of the curve. Deciding these all things, we will prepare a table for different points, that the points which can lie on the curve, and we will make a table for different values of theta versus r. This will give us points which can lie on the curve or which are lying on the curve. By plotting this point on the plane and using the other properties that we discussed earlier, we'll be able to find or we'll be able to trace a polar curve. First of all, in tracing of polar curve, we are going to discuss two obvious curves which can be just discussed or which can be just drawn or traced using simple properties. The polar curve for which r is constant, that is theta can take any value, r is constant is the curve. For example, I have taken here the curve r equal to 2. Curve r equal to 2 is consists of all points r theta for which r is 2. R represents the distance from the point to the pole. Meaning to say, if I am choosing r as 2, it will give me distance of this point from pole. And as it is said that take any value of theta, keeping r as 2 fixed, it will give us a figure of a circle. That means r equal to 2 represents the circle with center pole or O and radius 2. In general, the equation r equal to a represents a circle with center O and radius mod a. Similarly, we are going to sketch the next curve, which is theta equal to constant curve, theta equal to 1, I have taken for an example. This is the curve consists of all points r theta for which r can be anything, theta must be 1, that is taken in radian, theta is taken in radian. It is the straight line that passes through O and makes an angle 1 with polar axis. as r can take any value, that we, the points which can lie on this curve can be anywhere on the line theta equal to 1. So on the line with r greater than 0 in the first quadrant and on the line r less than 0 in the third quadrant will have this type of sketch of theta equal to 1. These are the points. These points are used in polar form. Theta equal to 1 line we are having, and distance is r1 this side. If we take distance 1 from this side, it will be considered as minus 1, 1 point, minus 2, 1 point. Whatever theta is here, we'll take the same theta, but we'll consider pi plus theta as an angle, and we'll have this much points. So this will give us theta equal to 1 line, theta equal to 1 line in the plane. So these two curves are obvious, r equals to a and theta equals to constant. R equal to a will give you circles on polar plane, while theta equal to constants will give you lines on polar plane. Let us sketch the curves using the properties that we have discussed. Starting with the first curve, sketch the curve r equal to 2 cos theta. Starting with the first property, symmetricity or symmetry. Since the given curve r equal to 2 cos theta is symmetrical to polar axis, since in the equation of curve, if we replace theta by minus theta, if I replace here theta by minus theta, because of this cos, we'll get cos theta back. So we'll get got the equation of curve back if we replace theta by minus theta. Equation remains unchanged. So we can say that our given curve is symmetrical to polar axis, because by changing theta by minus theta, the equation of curve remains unchanged. Okay, we can discuss here also symmetricity with respect to normal line or theta equal to pi by 2 line. For that, I have to replace here theta by pi minus theta, and we all know that in second quadrant cos is negative. So if I try to replace this theta by pi minus theta, I'll get r equal to minus 2 cos theta, which should not be done. R cannot be negative. So this curve is not symmetrical with respect to perpendicular line or normal line. It is not symmetrical to pole also, because to be symmetrical with pole, if we replace theta by pi plus theta, the equation of curve should remain unchanged. If we replace theta by pi plus theta, we'll get cos pi plus theta in the equation, and as we know that cos is also negative in third quadrant, we'll get r equal to minus 2 cos theta. We'll not get the same equation of curve. Equation of curve is getting changed. Therefore, this curve cannot be symmetrical to pole. So final conclusion is, the curve is symmetrical with respect to only theta equal to 0 line, that is polar axis. And because of this symmetricity, it will remain symmetrical to polar axis only, this discussion. The curve r equal to 2 cos theta. Again, the next property we have to discuss. The property is pole and tangents at pole. The curve passes through pole or not, that we have to check. What we'll do? Curve will pass through pole if its distance from pole, if a point lies on a curve, has distance from pole as 0. So what I did, I put r equal to 0 in the equation of curve. I got 2 cos theta equal to 0, that leads me to cos theta equal to 0. By solving this equation, cos theta equal to 0, I'll get theta's value as pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2. Cos theta can become 0 when theta is pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2. This means that the curve passes through pole at 0 pi by 2 and 0 3 pi by 2. the lines theta equal to pi by 2 and theta equal to 3 pi by 2 are tangents to the curve r equal to 2 cos theta. Next, extent. Now to find a region of the curve, a region where the curve can lie, in the equation of curve, this is the equation of curve, r equal to 2 cos theta, we have to check out that for which values of theta r can become negative or imaginary. If we consider cos theta will become negative when theta will become, or when theta will be between pi by 2, 3 pi by 2. So we can say that there is no branch of curve for theta's value as pi by 2, 3 pi by 2. For remaining all values of theta, the curve will exist. I think there must be a slight change here. Theta between pi by 2 to 5 pi by 2 I should use. Yes, it must be theta between pi by 2 to, no, it is okay. Theta between pi by 2, 3 pi by 2. So curve is, r's value is negative between pi by 2, 3 pi by 2. And therefore, the curve should not have any branch for these values of theta. Now, which are these values? These are the values which are on the left hand side of the given plane. Now if we take r equal to 2, if we consider cos theta can take maximum value as 1. So r's maximum value can be 2. So r equal to 2, therefore curve lies inside a circle having radius r equal to 2. Is the maximum value. Special point on the curve. First we find the values of r for this, for some convenient values of theta. We plot the corresponding points r theta. Then we join these points to sketch the curves as follows. This slide contains the points, the table for the points of theta versus r and the sketch of the curve. As you can see here, I have taken in account only those values which lies between 0 to pi by 2. For 3 pi by 2 to 2 pi, I can simply use symmetry. Because I have proved somewhere that this given curve is symmetrical to initial line. So whatever points I'll plot here, that points will be same on the either side of the polar axis. So I'm going to find out the tabulated value for 0 to pi by 2 only, between 0 to pi by 2 only. For theta equal to 0, if I put cos 0, if I put theta equal to 0 here, I'll get to r equal to 2. Theta equal to pi by 6, I'll get cos pi by 6, which will be root 3. Cos pi by 4 will be root 2, pi by 3 which will be 1, and pi by 2 which will give me value 0. Now plotting these all values on plane, this is the theta equal to 0 line, theta equal to pi by 6 line, theta equal to pi by 4 line, and theta equal to pi by 3 line, and theta equal to pi by 2 line. Let us first of all put these points on the curve. 0, then r is 2. So 0, 2. And r theta point. So 2, 0 point. Root 3 pi by 6 point. Then root 2 pi by 4 point. And 1 pi by 3 point. Now if I take, if I use symmetricity, I'll get this figure of the curve. As we discussed earlier, the curve cannot lie in second and third quadrant. This is a curve which does not lie second and third quadrant. Also, we discussed that curve is passing through pole, and at pole, the curve's tangent is theta equal to pi by 2 line itself. So this was all about the curve r square equal to r equal to a cos 2 theta or 2 cos 2 theta cos theta. Sketch the curve r equal to cos 2 theta. Similar way we will go. We will check out symmetricity with respect to polar axis, normal axis and pole, which is shown here. If we replace theta by minus theta, I will get cos 2 theta back. So curve is symmetrical to polar axis. If I replace theta by pi minus theta, I'll get cos of 2 times pi minus theta, which will be cos 2 theta. And if I replace theta by pi plus theta, I'll get cos of 2 pi plus theta, which will be cos 2 pi plus 2 theta. And that will be cos 2 pi plus 2 theta will give us the the point in the first quadrant. So identically, since cos is positive in first quadrant, I'll get cos 2 theta as answer. So finally, we are having this much conclusion. The curve is symmetrical to polar axis, the curve is symmetrical to normal axis, the curve is symmetrical to pole. To find that the curve is passing through pole or not, we have to find out those points on curve for which r is 0. So just putting r equal to 0 in the equation of curve, I'll get cos 2 theta equal to 0. That means 2 theta is pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2. That will lead me pi by 4 and 3 pi by 4 values of, 4 values of theta. I can also go for 5 pi by 2 and 7 pi by 2 using the same reason. And that will lead me theta's value as 5 pi by 4 and 7 pi by 4. This means that the curve passes through pole at 0 pi by 4, 0 3 pi by 4, 0 5 pi by 4 and 0 7 pi by 4. And lines theta equal to pi by 4, 3 pi by 4, 5 pi by 4 and 7 pi by 4 are tangent lines to the curve. R equal to cos 2 theta. Extent means a region where curve can lie. Since cos can we take its maximum value as 1, r equals to 1 is the maximum value of the curve of the r which can be on the curve. So curve must lie in the radius, in the circle having radius 1. Since cosine between pi by 2 3 pi by 2 is negative, cos 2 theta will be negative between pi by 2 to 3 pi by 4 to 3 pi by 4 and 5 pi by 4 to 7 pi by 4. So branch of curve lies between pi by 4 to 3 pi by 4 and 5 pi by 4 to 7 pi by 4. That should be added here in the region or extent. Spatial points on the curve, the points on the curve for which for which r and theta can take permissible values. We find the values of r for some convenient values of theta. We'll plot the corresponding points r theta and then we join these points to find out the trace of the curve or sketch of the curve. Here we have used the points which lies between zero to 2 pi. But because we are having r equal to cos 2 theta, it will be better if we take theta from 0 to 4 pi. As you can see in the figure, we have found different values of r just putting values of theta. When theta is 0 or theta is pi by 2 or theta is pi, we'll have the maximum value of r. And remaining values can be obtained using increasing sequence. This will make us increasing of the curve from this point to this point and then from this point to this point, increasing then decreasing, increasing then decreasing, increasing then decreasing, increasing then decreasing. So tabulated values of theta and r will form this curve. This curve is also called Rho's curve. R equal to cos 2 theta is also called rose curve, or it is also called four leaf curve. Let us see one more problem. Trace the curve r equal to a into 1 plus cos theta. The equation of the curve remains same by replacing theta by minus theta. If in this equation, if I replace theta by minus theta, there will not be any change in the equation of curve, because cos minus theta is cos theta. So this curve will be symmetrical to polar axis. It cannot be symmetrical to normal axis, because if I replace theta by pi minus theta, cos pi minus theta is minus cos theta, equation will get changed. Here it cannot be replaced, it cannot be symmetrical with pole also. So this curve is symmetrical to only polar axis region. The curve exists for all values of theta. We are having r equals to a into 1 plus cos theta, and cos can take maximum values between minus 1 to 1 for any theta. So for any theta, the r will always be positive, and this says that curve exists for all values of theta. We have r equal to a into 1 plus cos theta, and minus 1 less than or equal to cos theta less than or equal to 1. The cos theta can take maximum value 1. So r can take its maximum value as 2a. So whatever figure of the curve we require, that must lie in the circle having radius 2a. Our total curve lies between within the circle r equal to, having radius r equal to 2a. Pole and tangents at pole. To find pole, we have to find out the point or the values of theta where r can become 0. This is 0. If we put in the equation of curve r equal to 0, we'll get a into 1 plus cos theta equal to 0. That is 1 plus cos theta equal to 0. That is cos theta equal to minus 1. And cos theta is minus 1 when theta is pi or minus pi. So for theta equal to plus or minus pi, r becomes 0. Therefore, the curve passes through pole at 0 pi and 0 minus pi point. 0 pi and 0 minus pi points are the tangents to the curve at pole. Points of intersection. We have to also find the points on curve. These are the points on curve, or it can be considered as points of intersection. The curve meets initial line at 2a 0, 0, 0, a pi by 2 and a 3 pi by 2. To theta equal to pi by 2 line. So if we consider this table, we are having theta versus r table. The values are used from 0 to pi because the curve is not symmetrical to vertical line. So we have used different values of theta and r, and using these values and points, we will be able to trace the curve on the plane. A point, pole, curve is passing through pole at theta equal to pi. So theta equal to pi is tangent to the curve at pole. 2a equal to 2a 0 is initial line. Theta equal to pi by 2 is normal line. And using properties, all given properties of the curve, that r can lie between a circle having radius 2a, we can have this figure of the curve. It is also called cardioid. Now we are going to discuss few more problems using table 2. Trace r square equal to a square cos 2 theta. This is again a polar equation, r equal to f theta. Since equation of curve remains unchanged when we replace theta by minus theta. If here in this equation, if I replace theta by minus theta, equation of curve will not get changed. So this curve is symmetrical to initial line, that is theta equal to 0 line, as well as it will not get changed if I replace theta by pi minus theta, because I am in cos 2 theta. So it is symmetrical to theta equal to pi by 2 line also. Now to find out poles, this was all about symmetry. To find pole, what we will do, we will find out the point on the curve where r is 0. For that we have to use this equation of the curve, r square equal to a square cos 2 theta, and we have to replace r by 0. So that will lead us a square cos 2 theta equal to 0. By solving this, we will have cos 2 theta as 0, which will lead us theta is equal to either pi by 4 or 3 pi by 4 or 5 pi by 4 or 7 pi by 4. So r is 0 when theta takes either pi by 4, 3 pi by 4, 5 pi by 4, 7 pi by 4 values. This will also work as tangent to the curve at pole. And the final decision is, or final conclusion is, curve is passing through pole and we have total 4 tangents at pole. Region. Since maximum value of cos 2 theta is 1, therefore maximum value of r is a. Therefore, the whole curve lies in circle of radius r equals to a. The curve that we want to trace lies in the circle of radius r equals to a. Also, we have cos 2 theta less than 0 when theta 2 theta lies between pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. That means when theta lies between pi by 4 to 3 pi by 4. And similarly for pi by 4 to 7 pi by 4. Therefore, we cannot have any part of the curve for the values of theta between pi by 4 to 3 pi by 4 and 5 pi by 4 to 7 pi by 4. And now, special points on the curve. We are having theta and r's different values that we have chosen here to trace the curve. I will use only those thetas which lies between 0 to pi by 4, because the curve is symmetrical with respect to polar axis and normal axis both. I have chosen only the theta's values which lies between 0 to pi by 4. As we have discussed that there will not be any part of curve between pi by 4 to pi by 2. So I have not chosen that values of theta. For between theta's value between 0 to pi by 4, the r will become a by 2 raised to 1 by 4, a by root 2 and 0. So by putting all points on the curve, we'll have finally this sketch of the curve. As we derived, r equal, the curve lies in the circle of radius r equal to a, theta equal to pi by 4, theta equal to 3 pi by 4, theta equal to 5 pi by 4 and theta equal to 7 pi by 4 are tangents to the curve. The point 0 theta is pole, out of which the curve is passing through 0 pi by 4 point, 0 5 pi by 4 point, 3 pi by 4 point, 5 pi by 4 point and 7 pi by 4 point from the pole. The curve are drawn this way because these are the tangents to the curve. So r square equal to a square cos 2 theta can be geometrically figured by this way. Students, we have discussed in this 4 parts of sketching of curves, we have discussed that how we can trace or how we can sketch a curve given in either Cartesian or polar form. We have gone through different properties which will help us in future to identify a curve as well as to use a curve in either way. The curves can be utilized, or the geometrical figures of the curve can be utilized in multiple integrals as well as in applications of integration topics of our syllabus. So idea of tracing of curves is an important point. The students should be aware of this all things. Use and sketch more and more curves at your home and try to sketch the curves using the properties that we have discussed in last 4 sessions. Thank you for listening to me.